Good morning, everybody. We're learning the Chafetz Chaim. We're learning the ways of Tzaddikim. Thank you for being with us. We're learning today just to see what the Shiur number is. We're learning the Gate of Simcha, Shara Simcha, Ochot Tzaddikim, the Hebrew version, page pay. And we're learning the Gate of the Simcha. We're in lesson 49 and part 9 of this Gate of Simcha. Rav spoke before about thoughts, different thoughts, how to acquire, how to connect to the bitachon and emuna, to the trust and faith in Hashem that within you. What thoughts will connect you to the inner yourself of, if I may, the inner yourself, the koach ha-pnimi, the internal strength that you have, the neshama, that would keep you in bitachon and trust and in emuna, in faith in HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So we are in the sixth thought that the Rav is sharing with us, how to reach it. So the sixth, Hashishi, the sixth thought, Sheikach el libo lekayem ma shetzivahu. Take in your heart what Hashem commanded you. Limana mikol ma shizihu shelo lasot, and prevent or don't do anything that Chachamim or the Torah, the name of the Torah, warned you not to do. Says the Rav, Kasher chafetz, כאשר הוא חפץ שהבורא תלה, יעשה לו הדבר שהוא בוטח בו. Just as you trust הקדוש ברוך הוא to do something for you, that you trust הקדוש ברוך הוא, I mean, you have some kind of a ביטחון פנימי, internal ביטחון, trust, the same, in yourself, even צדיקים do that, Hashem, you know, I'm giving everything for you. I'm willing to live on water and bread. Please take care of me. What am I asking? I'm asking for good family, I'm asking for בריאות, I'm asking for לילה פרנסה. When you have that trust, Chachamim trust Hashem. What is the trust? It's coming from Bitachon. Some people, I heard a story that his Rav in Israel was going to the Kotel with a friend of his with no money, and they took a taxi. And the guy said, how come we take a taxi? We don't have money. He said, don't worry, it's going to be fine. But that's such high level of Bitachon. And something happened on the way that somebody joined and paid for the taxi. So, and this is very high people, very high bitachon that we're not at this level. Or they took a taxi to Rabbi Shimon, and they didn't have so much money on them, barely to pay. And the taxi driver saw that the Rav is so trusting, and he spoke some Torah. He didn't let him pay for the taxi from Yerushalayim to the Rabbi Shimon, which is very far. Plus, he also paid him for the food to make a ilula over there in Rabbi Shimon. Because he told him he went to Rabbi Shimon to make a odaya, seudat odaya, to thank HaKadosh Baruch for something Hashem did for him. I don't remember what. And the taxi driver was so impressed, them, no, you don't pay for me. Plus, he paid him for the food, for the seudah. Over there, there was a restaurant in Meron to go to the Rabbi Shimon and be able to pay. So you see some people, such a trust in Hashem, and they're so careful to do the will of Hashem, that Hashem really fulfill the wills, like he says, it's really connected to what we said. Kedivrei Rabotenu, like Chachamim, like our rabbi says, we're in Avot, Perek Daled, Man De'amar, says here, Ase Retzono Kirtzoncha. Do his will, like your will. So the Rav says, you should do the will of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. You should do the will of HaKadosh Baruch Hu just as your will, meaning if you do take the will of Hashem and you make it your will, meaning Hashem wants me to be nice, Hashem wants me to eat kasher, Hashem wants me to be peaceful with people, Hashem wants me not to be egoist, Hashem wants me to put my honor, to put His honor before my honor, Hashem wants me to respect my parents, Hashem wants me to have shalom bayit with my wife. If I do things like that, continue the Mishnah in Avot, Yesh Yaseh Retzoncha Kirtzono, and Hashem will do His will like your will. So when you do the will of Hashem, when you do the will of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, Hashem takes your will and fulfill it before His will. Batel Retzoncha Lifnei Retzono, that's another thing says the Mishnah here. Cancel your will before the will of Hashem, כדי שיבטל רצון אחרים לפני רצונך. You cancel your will before the will of Hashem. Hashem will cancel other wills before your will. You will see it in life.
pay attention if you see that the Kadosh Baruch Hu will make sure that if your will is true according to the Torah, you're a man of Torah, if you do everything according to the Torah, the advantage is that the Kadosh Baruch Hu will cancel other people's thoughts that will bother you to fulfill the will of Hashem. Why? Because the level of fulfilling the Kadosh Baruch Hu's will is the highest will there is in life. אבל מי שבוטח בשם מתעלה ואינו מקיים מה שציווה הוא, but a person who trusts Hashem מתעלה ואינו מקווה מה שציווה הוא, but if a person trusts Hashem, but on the other end, he doesn't do what Hashem commanded him. You know these kind of people? I trust the Kadosh Baruch Hu. Where is the Shabbat? I trust Hashem, don't worry. I give food to poor people. I give tzedakah once a year to the shul. I give $180 when the Rav calls me. I'm good, I'm a tzaddik. I help my kids. Everybody loves me. But I don't do the will of HaKadosh Baruch Hu, but it's okay, don't worry. So says the Rav here, if a person does that, כמה הוא שוטה וכסיל, how much is silly and unwise, using the cleanest word. כסיל is like טיפש, like stupid. אבל זה נאמר, and by this says in Eov, chapter חף זין, עד חף, עד חף חד, no, sorry, chapter חף זין, פסוק חת and תת. מה, כי מה תקוות חנף כי יבצה, כי יש אל אלוה נפשו. זה... what is the hope of a person who has kissed up to people like he's doing sins against the Torah? HaKadosh Baruch Hu will save his nefesh, his soul. Atzakato Yishmael, this is the pasuk. Will Hashem hear his crying? He says, no, you have to do the will of Hashem for him to fulfill your will. But if you do everything according just to what you invented, you think you're smart and you don't keep the mitzvot, and you don't go according to the Chachamim, because Chachamim show you the spirit of the Torah. Like we said before, the art, another book was the art of being a Jew. And like he says in Yirmiyah, Zayin, chapter Zayin, Pasuk Tet, and Pasuk Yud, Agonev, Aganov, Ratzoach, Menaof, Vishavea, Lashaker, Vekatel, Labal. You think that you will steal and cheat, and you will swear to the lie. And you will put sacrifices to the Baal to idol worship him. And you will go after other gods, asher lo yadatem, that you didn't know before. Meaning, I didn't take you out of Egypt. And you came to my house, to the Bet HaMikdash, or to the, in this case, Bet HaMikdash, Yirmiyah HaNavi, Bet HaMikdash. Babayit hazeh asher nikrash mi'alav. You're going in your chutzpah, and you're stealing, and you're murdering, and you're swearing to Sheker. And you put idol worshiping sacrifices, and you're going after other gods that you didn't know, and you come to my house that my name is upon it, like Bet HaMikdash. Ve'omer also the Yirmiyah HaNavi says over there, Pasuk Yud Alef, Ha'me'arat paritzim hazeh habayit, asher nikra shmi alav be'enechem. Is this a house of thieves, a house of sinners, a house of people who go against my name? You think the Bet HaMikdash is? You think that you can go and do other things and come? You think that you can, I'll explain, you think that you can desecrate the Shabbat? Maybe in today's generation I can desecrate with my humble opinion, what he says the Rav. What says Yom HaNavi? You think you can desecrate the Torah, eat non-kosher, not put filim, go against the Torah in any aspect, put your kids in public school so they don't even know what mezuzah is, they don't even know how to make bar mitzvah, they don't even know what the talit is. They don't know even have a word in Hebrew. And you think you can come in Yom Kippur and say, Chatanu, Avinu, Pashanu, and it's done. And then you know the next day, the next Shabbat, you're going to drive. Yom Kippur is a joke for you. Even if you go and you cry over there, and you, because you believe Hashem will forgive you, what do you think? If you don't take upon yourself at least something small to start next year. Something small is to keep Shabbat, by the way. People are afraid. Take things small. Something small is to keep Shabbat. I'm not going to drive in Shabbat next year. You're asking for Chatanu, Avinu, Pashanu. Hashem, I'm so sorry. Many people do that. Many people do that. They come to the shul and they mean what they do, but they know for sure next Shabbat they're not going to keep kosher. Next day You think you can go to follow other gods, the gods of non-kosher food, the god of not keeping Shabbat, and you're going to go come to my house. What is the house today? Yom Kippur is the holiest day of the year. It's probably the closest day of a shul is similar to the Holy Temple in Yerushalayim. And you pray over there, and you know that the next day you're going to go against me? You think that I need that? Like Pasuk, this is Yirmiyah Navi, not us. Also in Tehilim, he says the Pasuk, I have all the sacrifices in the world, all the bulls in the world. You think that I need your axe to sacrifice for me? It's for you. This is the seventh thought. And again, if we went a little bit harsh, because the Sefer goes a little bit harsh, you have to subdue. This is what it means to subdue yourself. You learn a book, give the book life according to what the Rav says. Over here we spoke in the name of Yirmiyah Navi. Yirmiyah Navi says that. He brings in his book, in chapter Zayin, Pasuk Tet, and Yud and Yud Aleph. He says the one we just said. The seventh thought. שידע כי הבורא ברוך הוא ברא את האדם למלאכות רבות. You should know, that's the seventh thought. הקדוש ברוך הוא, God, Hashem himself created you for many, many, many tasks and obligations. He says tasks, I'm adding obligations. הוא ברא לו מזונו על ידי תורח גדול ועבודה. And Hashem created for you your parnasa, your bread, your house, the mortgage to be able to pay, the work that you do, everything around you, by big toach v'avodah. Hashem commanded you that you have to work hard to achieve Torah, to achieve bread, to achieve parnasa, to buy a house, to support your kids. It's not easy. Ve'im ayu kol ha'nyanim v'amzot v'abgadim buchanim la'adam belot toach. And if all the things in life, like your clothing, your food, he says the food, the clothing, you see that food is more important than clothing. The food, the clothing, were ready for you without were asked to work hard. As lo yakama mitzvot, that you didn't have to do mitzvot. And a part of the hardship in life, to be able to do mitzvot, to do the business right, to treat the worker right, to have to go to the food, get ready for Shabbat, buy the food, prepare the food, honor of Shabbat, and buy clothes for Shabbat.
Food is more important because we need food for to learning the Torah. Then
exactly.
Yeah, and even when they were in a Bamidbar, they had one clothes that was growing constantly, right? But they had food every day, so we can actually see what's more important. Yeah. Otherwise, they would have more clothes.
Yes. So they said clothes first. You can
food
you can
first.
You can bring this to anything.
Yeah.
Laws, work, whatever you need. Yeah. The food is first because it keeps you survive, yeah. So see, if you did not, if everything was so easy for you, like the clothes were, the food was ready for you, the clothes were ready for you, you didn't have to work hard to get them, you were losing mitzvot, okay? For example, like, such as tzedakah, giving tzedakah, gzela, you wouldn't do fulfill the mitzvah of not stealing. Agneva ve'achemda, gezel is not really stealing, it's a different word. Stealing is, gezel is like cheating somebody and misleading him, or even taking something during the day, go to a store during the day, pretend like you paid for it and get out. A thief comes at night, a gazlan comes even during the day, he has many tricks to cheat you. So a gezel and gneva and chemda, and also liking somebody else's, because you work hard, you see somebody else's profit, you're jealous. The jealousy comes because you work hard and you didn't achieve what he achieved. So how do you get the chance to fix your jealousy? By working hard and see somebody else also go more than you. It's a merit for you to try to conquer the jealousy trait. For example, if you recognize you have a jealousy, example, you should work on it. You should be happy that you recognize that you have this trait, because you can fix yourself. Ve'rabot mitzvot kaile, many, many mitzvot like this, that by watching, that by the fact that Hashem gives you everything by hardship, meaning that you have to work hard, you have to wake up in the morning, come to pray, go to work, maintain your job, maintain your name, go to meetings, go to obligations, and then this is difficult, then you're tired, you still have to go. Life is not easy. You have to work hard to educate your kids, every morning take them to school, and so on and so forth. ורבות מצוות כאלה, many mitzvot like this. גם לא היה אדם בוטח באלוהים. Without this mitzvot, you wouldn't even have a trust in Hashem. ועל זה, we'll see before I give an explanation,
ועל זה גנז חזקיהו מלך יהודה. And on this, the king of יהודה, חזקיהו המלך, hidden, he cut away, shredded. That's the shredded the book of refuot, the book of healings. They used to have a book of healings, and he shredded. This in the bracha, like you probably saw, מסכת ברכות יהוד עמוד ב', כדי שיפתח החולה באלוהים ויתעלה ולא ברפואות. So what? So sick people would trust in הקדוש ברוך הוא, and not in the medicine. People probably used to do the medicine, they used to know the medicine of the body so good, they knew I don't have to trust Hashem, I know exactly what to buy, to mix, to get healed. So he said, no, I'm going to hide it away. Hashem can hide you, can heal you without medicine. Don't think that the medicine, the refua, the healings come from the medicine, comes from הקדוש ברוך הוא. Person goes to a doctor. He has an issue, not on us, not on anybody from Israel. He should know. You need to pay to Hashem to give the knowledge to the doctor and to send him to the right doctor or the right surgeon to do the surgery or the healings, the treatment right or the procedure right. He's going to get healed. He cannot trust the doctor. Some people, the God, the doctor becomes their God. They give him a gift and it's good to show appreciation to the doctor. And they say, I'm going to come. And right away they see him, and let's say their son, how are you, doctor? Like, they're going to be nice to him, so they take care of them. No, if you're unhappy, continue to be. If you're in pain, why? It's good to be nice to the doctor, but don't think because you're nice to him, you're going to get healings. Why? The doctor is an idol? No, it's just an instrument of Hashem to give you the healings. It's a part of bitachon.
Yeah, when Ermiyahu got sick, that was one of his healings, that he is actually hid the book. That was the part of the healing process for the Ermiyahu.
Ah, but created bitachon.
Yeah.
I think that Chizkiyahu HaMelech is the one that says also, Hashem ilachem lachem v'atem tacharishun, meaning, you're not going to do anything, and Hashem will fight your war. So his tikkun was bitachon. וגם אם היה אדם בטל ממלאכה, and also if a person didn't have to work, everything would come easily, ולא היה תורך אחר בזרותיו, and didn't have to work after his food, his water, his food, his clothing, היה בועט ורודף אחר העבודות. He would beat up and run after the העבירות. היה בועט ורודף אחר העבירות. He would run away and chasing the עבירות. If a person was bored, didn't have to invest so much time in making a living. But don't get it wrong. This blessing, you know, that we got from Hashem, בזד עתך תוכל לכם, ישבור הקר, applies to even everybody, even הרב. הרב has a job. He has to be too open to the public, he has to accept the public, even the person who annoys him. Right? I hope nobody annoys the rab. In general, not necessarily in our קהילה. He has to be in the shul before everybody, he has to show set example every second. Even when he's upset, he has to control him more than anybody else because he's showing an example. If a guy is learning the calling, he needs to work, he's getting salary. Even if he's dead tired, he needs to show up. If he doesn't come so many times, they will tell him. Tata, there's other people who want to come to the calling. There's a waiting list. He has to perform. He has tests to show his knowledge. So there's pressure for everybody. His wife expects him to go to the learning. His parents who support him expect him to go to the learning. So everybody has pressure. Don't think, oh, look at this Tamidei Chachamim, they sit in the koil all day long. You think it's easy? Go to try it. Have your father, instead of you wearing Versace shoes and driving a Lexus, tell your father, I'm going to go to yeshiva for 10 hours a day. Give me half of the salary, I don't need that much. I'm going to learn 10 hours. I see your father will call your rav. How is he learning? How is he doing? What time is coming to shul? You think that it's easy? Everybody have a pressure in life. Everybody have something that they have to, somebody they have to answer to everybody. And it says the rav, it's good. Because without this, you would run and go after the sins. Person is bored, when he's sin, when he's bored. I said bored?
Bored.
I'm not bored. What's it about to do?
Bored.
I don't pronounce the name right.
B-O-R-E-D.
Bored. Pidichtim, like it says in the book of Dvarim, Lamed Bet Pasuk Ket Zayin, Vayishman Yishurut Vayivat. In the Torah it says, Yishurun is the nation of Israel. ישירון, לספור ישראל, לספור סוף, לאיזשהו ליר, את כל אדם ישירון, ישירון, ולושו ישר. The nation of straightness is the nation of Israel. וישמן, and they, the nation of Israel become fat, and they kicked the mitzvot. Why? Life is good. What do you want? Life is good, I'm good. I'm making money, life is good, I got honor. I come on Yom Kippur to do the sins. Chatati, Abiti, Pashati, and everything will be fine.
I'm comfortable,
yeah. ואמרו אבותינו זכרונם לברכה, and our sages, they said, in אבות, again, in מסכת אבות פרק ב', chapter ב', second, מ' ב', יפה תלמוד תורה, עם דרך ארץ, it's good to have learning of Torah, with דרך ארץ, with work. Why? שהגיעתם, הגיעת שניהם, משכחת אבון. Because when you work hard on both of them, it reduces, it forgets the sins. Over here, the commentary says, why is it so nice to have both of them? Talmud Torah also work. לפי ששני הדברים הללו עומדים כנגד דברים הרבה, because these two things are standing for you against other many temptations. When you work, you have no time to sin, no time to drink, no time to look at not proper things. But when you learn, of course, it's healing your nefesh, it's giving you bitachon. Both of them stand up like ammunition against different enemies. ושני אלה משכחים אבון. And both of them are giving forgiveness or making the אבון, the sin, go away. If you're busy and you sweat and you work, plus you're learning, you're together, you're keeping right, you're keeping kosher, you're keeping being a tzaddik, plus you're working hard, so you don't have time to make mistakes. It's like a circle. You work, you bring bread home, bring work to Shabbat, parnasah to your kids, and you learn in the morning, try to learn in the night, trying in the middle of the day. Today is so easy, you can put a tape, you can play a tape and you can learn in the car. You put a CD and you play on the CD, you go to work. Many people work in high tech business, they can have earphones while they're working. Put the Dvar Torah. I remember I had an electric job done in my house, and the electrician was Jewish, his work was not. So I asked him, what do you listen to? He said, I listen to the Christians. We listen to Torah, or to, not to Torah, to the Bible things all day long. You know what he listens to, but it's you can learn from this. Look, the guy walks in, you know, according to him, he's making a mitzvah, he's listening to God's word. Achata, of course, according to Isabel, החטא מסר השם, we know that we're not supposed to listen to the New Testament as Jews, it's not a part of our Torah. The Torah says specifically, you cannot add a letter to the Torah. The Torah that adds a letter is a passing Torah. You have to remove the letter. So if you add a whole chapter, of course it's not allowed to according to a Jewish religion. החטא מסר השם מתעלה, but now, הקדוש ברוך הוא, gave us, obligated us, שתי עבודות ביד האדם. He gave us two responsibilities, two work, two jobs in our hands. האחת, the first job, עבודתו. והשנית, עבודת התורה. The first one is עבודתו, meaning worship of Hashem, putting sacrifices. והשנית, the second one is עבודת התורה, is the work of the Torah. How you call it? To learn Torah, to pray, to do the mitzvah, to work. When you work, you also do the mitzvah. Like the Rav says, you don't gezel, you don't steal, you're not jealous, you walk it clean, you're not cheating people. That's actually the Torah of believing. וצריך האדם להיות ממוצע בין שתי העבודות. Person needs to be average between the two jobs. Learn Torah, and also do the mitzvah. Do the mitzvah, the father do the mitzvah. This is the final job. If you arrive and you're the poly, you get a salary, that's a job. Because you need to learn Torah to sustain the city against all the people who don't learn Torah. We said in the other shul, that's Chaim. A city that doesn't have Torah learning constantly in it, it's a danger. Because the protection of the Torah protects the whole city. There was a big rav in Israel. But the kid, we talked about it before. I didn't have, maybe I have Kaniewski, I'm not sure who. A kid was going to the sidewalk and a bus hit him. The kid fell on the floor, died on the spot. There was a yarmulke below his head. Not too far, maybe 2-3 feet. He went to the Rav, then a Jewish kid died right now from a bus accident. The Rav said, it's impossible, it's not Jewish. It's impossible. I said, how can you be so sure? There was a yarmulke, black yarmulke next to him. He said, it's impossible for a city. I learned, I mean, for a street, in my street, we learned Torah for so dedicated, for so many, 40 years, for a kid to die. They went and checked, and the kid was not Jewish, he was an Arab kid. We also saw, of course, that everything died. But this was the point of the shiur, he was an Arab kid, who was a yarmulke, somebody dropped him on the street, nothing to do with him on the same spot. So, you see, the power of the Torah. Actually, the Torah really protects everybody. Not just the kid. The Torah is learned in the place. Protect the argument of that. They say, Oh, Rasha, Oh, Lishkeno. God protects the wicked people and his neighbors. So the other way we go, the other way is around the world. So a righteous person lives in a place. The city is protected, like we see in Sodom and Amora. King Lot was not removed, the city was not destroyed. Uliachet Shaot Miuchadot La Avodah Torah Melavodah Torah Olam Hazeh. You should dedicate set hours to work, to worship Hashem, and also to the work of this world. Everybody a good day, sorry for the noise from the vacuum cleaning the shul, thank you very much for listening to us.